Ladies and gentlemen, we are now arriving in New Canaan. We will be continuing on to Charlotte in exactly 10 minutes. If this is your final destination, please gather your belongings.
I was wondering if you could help me out. I'm not trying to sell you anything, nothing like that. I'm trying to track down someone who used to live here.
Oh, nobody's lived here but us.
Who's that?
Who exactly are you looking for?
Her name is Malarka Karnstein.
No, don't recall anybody by that name.
You sure?
Believe me, I'd remember a name like that, especially around these parts. Troy Pickett.
Carmilla.
Hi. Now, could that be like a nickname? I mean, could she be going by some other name?
No, it isn't. She passed through this town and she gave people this address for her mail.
This address?
Yes. So no one else lives here who might have known who she was?
No. Just me and my little girl. I'd invite you inside, but we're headed off to town. I'm so sorry we can't be more help to you.
It's okay. Thanks for trying.
Okay. Can I give you a ride into town?
Would you mind?
Not at all. Let me get my hat.
If I could get some information from the public records. I'm looking for police reports or calls to the police filed from a particular address.
What address is it?
4880 Highway 58.
4880?
Yes.
Troy Pickett's place.
That's right.
It'll be a couple of days.
Can't you get it any sooner?
Two business days.
Thank you.
What?
Not much of a detective. You were just at my house.
Oh, how was it?
Shit. I mean, sorry.
Any luck?
No.
Anyway.
Just coffee.
You're not gonna eat?
No, thanks.
Meet.
Look, the reason I didn't order lunch is because I don't. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sit for a sec. Thanks for this.
It's okay. Just play it cool, and I'll just charge you for the coffee. So, are you traveling all by yourself?
Mm-hmm.
Aren't you scared? So this Mallorca is, is she in some kind of trouble?
No, not that I know of.
Well, who is she? Or who was she?
Was, probably. But I don't even know that. At this point, I'm just looking for traces.
She owe you money or something?
She was my mother.
I'm sorry. Why didn't you just say so?
Would it have made a difference?
I guess not.
Besides, I'm looking for answers, not sympathy.
I'm sorry I said sorry. Well, when's the last time you saw her?
I never saw her.
She give you up?
Thank you for lunch. You're too nice.
She didn't live at the house. He wasn't lying about that, technically. Meet me back here at 3:00 and I'll show you what I mean.
Yeah.
I mean, it might be nothing.
Okay. I'm Carmilla Karnstein.
Laura. Laura Pickett.
I'll be here, Laura.
Thank you.
Daddy used to rent it out. But he stopped because it was too much of a headache.
And how long ago was that?
Years. I guess it's possible she could have lived here for a while and he just forgot. So where do you go from here?
Dunno. This was more or less the end of the trail.
Here?
She drifted around a lot. She had a tendency to skip out on rent.
That would explain a lot. So, if you don't expect to find your mother, are you thinking that if you follow in her footsteps, that she'll be closer to us somehow? Hey, I have an idea.
Pull your hand off the, all the way to the fence. All the way to the fence. There you go.
Whoa! Woo!
Pull back on the rein a little bit.
Whoa.
Pull back on the rein. Pull back on the rein.
Whoa!
Pull back on the rein.
Whoa!
I got it.
Whoa!
Whoa. There you go. There you go. Okay. Whoa. This way. Follow me. Keep your arms in.
I think he likes you better than me.
Yeah, I think so. Here we go.
Daddy?
Yes, ma'am.
You know that girl that came up to the house earlier today?
Uh-huh.
She came into the diner, too, this afternoon.
Talk to you?
No, to eat. We talked for a while, though. You know that woman she's looking for? Malarca? She was her mom.
That's so? Huh.
She stayed at the trailer, didn't she?
Yeah, for a time she did.
Why didn't you tell her?
Well, baby doll, it's complicated. But that girl's mother, she was a bad sort, into all kinds of bad things, and, for me to tell the girl that, I didn't see the good in it.
But it was her mom.
Yeah, it's all the more reason we shouldn't tell her. See, I know it sounds cruel, but sometimes it's best not to know something. And if I wasn't completely truthful with that girl, it's just because I didn't want to hurt her. And that's the God's honest truth. Yeah.
Still, I feel bad for her, though.
Yeah, I know you do. Because that's you. I feel the same way.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Because I told her it'd be all right if she stayed in the trailer. Just for a couple of nights. Please?
Okay.
Thank you, Daddy.
Go on now, go on.
Thank you.
morning.
I thought you might want to ride into town.
Thanks, but I'll just hoof it.
Daddy's going deer hunting this weekend, so I thought if you're still around, maybe we could take in a movie or something.
Look, just so you know, and so your father knows, I'm not looking to move in.
You're staying for a few days, right?
Just until I figure out where to go next.
Well, if you do go into town today, meet me at the diner at 3. I'll give you a lift home.
Okay.
My room's upstairs. If you see anything you want to borrow, just grab it.
All right.
I love that one.
She's beautiful.
Yeah.
Do you think maybe I could talk to her about
that? She died when I was 8.
I'm sorry. Shit, I get it now.
What?
Why didn't you say anything?
Come on, let's go. Silver Mustang anywhere? Oh, I think I see it over there. So, what do you say to someone when you think you like them, but you're not really sure? So, you wanna
Laura, don't take this the wrong way. As much as I'd like to help you, I don't think I'm the person to be giving you advice about men, boys, whatever.
Yeah, I have to.
That's something someone else should do.
I understand.
Friends? An aunt? Cousins? Anyone?
I'm sorry.
Stop apologizing. You're fine. Go have fun. I'll just wait here, I guess.
You're the best.
We promise to satisfy your hunger, your thirst, your sweet tooth. So visit our refreshment center now. Let's go! If you are thirsty, try ice cold soft drinks or a cup of hot, flavorful coffee.
Get something to go with it, like a sizzling and satisfying hot dog or a tasty
She has a date with a silver Mustang.
And listen to their screams.
What did you do to her?
And who are you, huh?
I'm the woman who wants you to get out of the car. Come on, get out of the car.
Back off, cunt.
Kill the engine! Get out of the car!
Car.
I so want you to get out of the car. Carmilla.
Take me home.
let them get away with shit like that. They're like bullies in a schoolyard. Once they see a weakness, they line up for a turn to exploit it.
It's not like that. I mean, I could say no.
Then why don't you? Is it the attention? Is this town that much of a shithole that the only way you can talk to a guy is with his dick in your mouth? I mean, don't get me wrong. I happen to like cock. I just don't like the assholes they're attached to. You ever think about maybe going away? Maybe to school?
I thought about it. Started saving up. Didn't get very far.
Well, there are other things you could do.
I mean, I want to be out on my own, but I'm just terrified at the idea of being all by myself.
Being alone's not so bad.
So, are you alone right now?
No. I'm with you.
You know what I mean?
To get off the road, and they're not familiar with the solitude you can have in the woods. People know so little bit about the woods. The woods is a friendly place.
I'm going to bed.
Treat wildlife and the outdoors with respect.
What'd you do tonight?
Went to the drive-in.
We'll make it a practice to observe all the rules of safe, responsible bow hunting.
That girl?
Practice each day before you go hunting. And ask the permission of property owners to hunt on
the. What do you all talk about?
While hunting, observe the rules of
fair chase. Nothing, just boys.
For your own safety,
then what?
Use a covered bow quiver. Never stalk with an arrow on
the
string.
Came back home, to the trailer, watch TV.
For the safety of others, never aim at anything you don't intend to shoot. Never shoot at an unseen target.
You know what? I can't help asking because I'm worried about you.
Daddy, you don't have to worry about me.
No. You a big girl now? And take care of yourself?
Yeah.
What if you run into the big bad wolf out there and you handle that?
Yeah.
Yeah. What if it's the devil himself and he reaches out and then he grabs you? You know, you're my everything, Laura. Just my everything. You know what? I made a covenant when your mother passed. I said I would never marry another woman, never look at her, until you were settled down with someone.
Daddy, I wouldn't mind if you did.
No. Come on, shh. That's my word, and I'm gonna keep it no matter what. Yeah? Oh, baby doll, you're my whole world, you know that? You're my whole world. You know, sometimes when I hold you here like this, and I close my eyes, sometimes I swear I could be with her.
You have a right to be angry.
Fuck you.
Oh, that's real nice.
That's the way you talk to people? People that take you in, give you a place to stay? Might be hard for you to understand, but I was only looking out for you.
No, you weren't. You just wanted me gone. But you're hiding something. I can see it in your face.
I'll tell you anything you want to know about Mallorca. You think that's going to make you happy? I got a feeling it won't. Come here. Come on.
You know what? I'm not looking for any favors or a handout. All I want to know, all I've wanted to know from the start, is just what she was like and where she might have gone after she left here. That's it.
Not gonna find that out reading those police reports, I'll tell you that. You know how she came to be here? She's driving across Route 20. Colored fella behind the wheel, guy by the name of Dwight, something rather. It was the middle of the night. We found out the next day they were trying to get to Montgomery by morning.
Montgomery.
So about the time they're coming through New Canaan, this Dwight fella, he falls asleep. He runs smack into a bridge support. Didn't kill him. Didn't kill neither one of them. But your mama was hurt worse because of the side of the road they went off on, so they took her off to the hospital. And this color fella, he goes on about how he's got to get to Montgomery, that his daddy is sick, close to death or some such thing. The car is scrap, total. And this fella reaches into your mother's pocketbook and he takes her money. Buys himself a bus ticket. Isn't that something? Yeah. Yeah. Leaves her there in the hospital, unconscious. But he gives her a note. Says, I'll be back in 5 days. Well, you can guess how that turned out, huh? So they call Montgomery. Call all the hospitals, but nobody's ever heard of this guy named Dwight. I suppose I can call down there and get his name if you like.
Lewis.
Oh, you know him.
I know all about him.
Ah. So they let her out of the hospital. What's she gonna do? Got no money. Doesn't act like she's got any place to go back to. So she takes a job waiting tables at the diner.
The diner?
My wife Karen took her in. She and Laura are a lot alike in that regard.
How long was she here?
Half a year. After a month or two, we asked if she could put something toward the rent. Laura was little, I was on disability. It was hard to make ends meet, but she didn't give us no money. Karen seemed to think she was on dope. One day she didn't turn up at the diner. Karen went down there to look for her. Malarca had up and moved out. Took a little TV and a radio we kept down there. We found it at the pawn shop in town.
You have no idea where she went after that.
See now, darling, when you steal something from somebody, you don't generally tell them where you're headed. I would have told you all this up front, but I didn't see the good in it.
I'll pay you something for the nights I was here.
No. No, you don't have to do that. But I tell you what. If you're planning on moving on, I'd prefer that you did it sooner rather than later. See, Laura has a tendency to get attached to people. And I don't want to see her get hurt no more. Okay.
I was wondering if you had a chance to search.
Got it for you right here.
Laura?
Baby doll, you all right?
You ran her off, didn't you?
No, I didn't. I told her what she came here to find out.
I liked having her here. I liked having someone to talk to.
Yeah, well...
And you ran her off because you're jealous.
No, I ran her off because if she's anything like her mother, she's dangerous.
Dangerous?
Yeah, I'm not about to let her hurt you the way she hurt your mother. See there? See what you get when you start asking too many questions? See, sometimes it's better off not to know something.
How did she hurt Mother?
You don't remember her. At all.
She and your mama worked at the diner together. Do you know that? Yeah, the two of them are pretty good friends, which I, for the life of me, couldn't understand. Your mama was a fine, you know, Christian woman. This Malarca, she wasn't worth shooting. I figured her for some kind of a gypsy, but your mama swore she wasn't. She acted, the way she put all kinds of ideas in your mama's head.
Like what?
like she was wonderful and beautiful.
So?
Like she was too good to be living out in the sticks, and she should run away with her, leave us behind, me and you. Well, yeah, the two of them used to run around a lot together, which pretty much left me to take care of you by myself.
I remember us sitting in a truck really late at night.
That's right.
You were spying on them.
That's right. I tried to tolerate it. I pretty much put up with anything. Make your mama happy. I mean, I loved her that much.
Your mother took to sleeping in the upstairs bedroom. I didn't know what else to do but to let her. Wasn't but a little bit, I started to see something different.
She started to look sickly. She started losing weight. She barely had the strength to get around. See, when she was alone with me, she tried acting like her same old self, but the spark just wasn't there. I mean, she was just tired all the time. And then she started having dizzy spells. So I took her to the doctor, and they thought she had some kind of a blood disorder. Yeah, they ran a bunch of tests. Anemia and leukemia, and they didn't know what they was looking for. Finally, I got fed up. I said, that's enough. I told them, that's it. I'll look for answers my own way. I ask the good Lord for guidance.
I remember.
I fasted and I prayed. Finally, you put the answer right here in my heart.
What did he say?
Go to sleep now, all right? I'm gonna be right in the next room.
I'll leave the hall light on.
I'm scared.
I'll be right here. Go to sleep now. See, I knew Malarka had something to do with it. And one night, I decided I was gonna find out what was going on.
What did you do?
Thank you.
was in the trailer rented to me by Troy Pickett.
Karen Pickett was staying at the trailer with me, having had a domestic disagreement with her husband. Son of a bitch. We have to go. The sooner the better. Where are your things?
I can't leave yet. There's something I have to tell you.
No, you don't have to. I read the police reports. I know.
Did the police report say why he did what he did?
Why he beat her half to death? Why he tried to run her over with the truck? No, I don't need to know.
You need to know.
Jesus Christ, Laura.
Isn't that why you came here? To find out who she was? Who they were? What they were?
My mother and your mother.
We're lovers. Did you know that?
I figured as much.
There's more. But you'll never believe me if I tell you.
Laura.
But I could show you. I never knew how much like my mother I was until now. How much we have in common. I've always hated myself for the way I am. But now I realize it's okay. It's how she was. All along, it was who I was meant to be. This is the way it was that night. When my father came down to the trailer and looked in the window. They were in this room. They were on this bed. We are now.
Laura? Oh, sweet Jesus.
Morning, Eddie.
You don't have to stay here, you know.
I can't leave.
Why not?
I was born here. This is where I belong.
Lord, hear all good prayers for us, for Jesus' sake. Second, what is this? What is that right there?
It's fine. I cut myself on the bread rack at work. It's fine.
Did you put some antiseptic on that?
Just eat, okay? I'm bushed, and I'm not looking forward to cleaning up the kitchen. You could help out a little more around here, you know?
Stay here, you know that.
Just a couple of nights. I've already paid for it.
Laura.
Please.
It's not that complicated. You drive to your house, pack some things, and we drive off.
I will. I just need to come up with an excuse.
You don't need an excuse. You're a goddamn adult. Sorry, one more time, and I swear to God. That's another thing.
What?
I'm thinking we should try it once without the knife.
Carmilla.
Relax. Jesus, Laura.
I tried to tell you. It's not because of them. It's because of me. It's who I am. But I don't cut myself anymore, I swear.
I know, because I do all the cutting for you.
Come here. It's just skin.
No more cutting, Laura.
Okay. Okay.
No more cutting. Not me, not you.
Spending time with that girl, haven't you?
A little.
Mm-hmm. After what I told you?
She's not her mother.
Yeah? What about you? Aren't you like your mother? You somebody totally different.
I wouldn't know.
Yeah. People don't know who they are till they get older. They got nothing in common with their parents and then find themselves doing the same thing their parents did. Believing in the same things and usually making the same mistakes. I hated my daddy. And I find myself more and more like him every day. And I'm just saying this because I'm trying to keep you from going down the same path that your mama did.
What's wrong with the path my mama took?
Would you stop arguing with me? You're just like your mama. You think you know everything. Don't listen to nobody. Look what it got her.
Malarka didn't kill my mother.
Oh, yeah, were you there?
Cancer killed my mother.
So the doctors say?
Oh, so you think you know better than the doctors?
I know what I saw with my own eyes. I seen your mother waste away to nothing. I looked into that Malarka woman's face.
Daddy.
Well, if you'd seen what I'd seen, I've never seen a look of such absolute evil in my life.
Would you come off it?
Would you listen to me? Just listen to me! Stop your moaning and your groaning and pay attention to someone that's trying to help you. You think you're so smart, you and her and the doctors, but couldn't none of you do nothing to save her? But I did!
Yeah. You tried to run her girlfriend over with your truck.
I did more than that.
What'd you do?
I caught her red-handed.
Laura! Laura! I'm not done talking to you. Laura!
Daddy wants to see you. I gotta see you. I just gotta look at you, baby, to know I'm not too late. If I thought anything bad was happening to you, Jesus.
It's not what you think. It's not. Daddy, wait. Where are you going?
Help will be here soon. Fuck. Thank you.
Where are you going? Tell me where you're going.
Doing here?
I had to see you.
But you can't. He'll kill you.
I just want to talk.
Oh, Lord, no, I can't.
Why? Because he says so?
It just isn't right.
Just for a minute.
Hey, you didn't say goodnight to me.
I'm sorry. Just really tired, that's all.
What?
I just got the chills.
Why don't you come downstairs and watch some TV with me?
Tomorrow.
Bed.
You are mine. You shall be mine. And you and I are one
to protect my family. If I just acted sooner,
done what I knew was in my heart was right. Maybe I could have saved her. But it was too late.
Lord, hear all good prayers for us. For Jesus' sake. Amen.
Mallorca had already fed upon your mother's blood. And your mother not only allowed it, she'd enjoyed it. Her blood, her soul, was poisoned. All I could do was keep her from spreading the evil to anyone else. I kept her under a tight rein. I dedicated myself to watching over the two of you, searching for signs of blood. Her blood.
Little.
And yours. Waiting for Malark or someone like her to come back, looking for us. And sure enough, she did.
Now you're old enough to know what I done and why I did it. And if that girl comes up into this room tonight, what it means?
What it
means? Means that she's like her mother. And what I done to her mother, I gotta do the same thing to her.
No, Daddy, please.
She'll come. Wait and see if she don't.
Please, Daddy. Please, give me a chance to explain. You don't understand. Daddy, please. She never hurt me. She never hurt me.
Thank you.
No, Carmilla, no. You gotta get out of here. You gotta get out of here.
Come here. I'm gonna take you out with her. I'm taking you with me.
No, I can't come.
Shh, stop.
No, no, please.
Listen.
No. Listen, you gotta get out of here.
No.
No, go. I want you to go. No.
Stop. Stop.
You gotta get out of here.
I'm fine, he won't. He's not gonna hurt me. Come on, Laura. Oh my God.
You have to leave, okay?
You don't have to ever come back here again.
Why can't you just go? Please! Go! Go! Get out of here! I don't want you here! Go! I don't want to go! I don't love you! You have to leave!
That's
you
not
have
true!
To look at me! Look at me, Carmilla. You have to leave.
Come on now.
Carmilla.
Oh, sure.